Dear teacher, we are students from Macau Pre-2 Middle School. I'm Chen Heyan.
I'm Kachon. The title of our report is Facile Synthesis of Chromium.NiSx Nanoflowers Nanomaterials as Ultra-Highly Efficient Electrocatalyst for Hydrogen Evolution Reaction. Our report is divided into five parts.
They are research background, material fabrication, material characterization, electrochemical testing of materials and conclusion of the research. Hydrogen energy is widely used nowadays. In terms of power, hydrogen energy can be used in a fuel-driven car, even in the research and application of rocket engines. Scientists are also developing hydrogen energy rockets. At present, 96% of the world's hydrogen is produced through fossil resources. Although this industrial hydrogen production method is cheap, but it consumes a lot of energy and generates a large amount of greenhouse gases, such as carbon dioxide, which is extremely unfavorable to the environment. Therefore, the electrocatalytic hydrogen evolution technology developed in recent years is considered to be a promising green hydrogen production technology. Water can produce hydrogen and oxygen by electrolysis. By means of overwater splitting, hydrogen can be produced at the working electrode and oxygen can be generated at the counter electrode. One of the keys to improving the performance of electrolyzed water is the electrocatalyst. At present, the ideal electrode material for producing hydrogen is platinum.
But the platinum is expensive and the storage content is small. Therefore, we want to find an easy way to produce hydrogen with a good performance and low price. That can greatly reduce the industrial use of fossil resources and reduce damage to the environment.
Although the current research is known that NiSx can produce hydrogen and oxygen as electrocatalysts, and the reserves are large and the price is low. However, the catalytic properties of electrosulfide are still not as good as platinum. So, we try to improve its performance by doping chromium in NiSx. The fabrication of chromium-doped NiSx nanomaterials is as follows. And let's watch the video.
We performed three characterizations on the synthesis material. They are SEM, XRD, TEM. It can be seen from the SEM imaging that compared with pure nickel sulfide and chromium-doped nickel sulfide material on the 1 micron line, it is found that the incorporation of chromium leads to a change in the morphology of the nickel sulfide material, the size is obviously smaller, the void becomes larger, and the absorption is increased better ability. The above two are pure and chromium dot nickel exophyte spectrum, and the following three standard spectra were nickel 1.19 sulfide, nickel sulfide, and trinickel disulfide. By comparison, it is found that the mild phase of pure nickel exophyte is nickel sulfide and trinickel disulfide. The mild phase of chromium dot nickel exophyte is nickel sulfide and nickel 1.19 sulfide. And chromium dot nickel exophyte is degradation peak has shifted. It means that chromium dot into pure nickel exophyte. It is seen from the TEM imagings. By comparing both pure nickel exophyte and chromium dot nickel exophyte material under the 20 nanometer line and 50 nanometer respectively, it is found that chromium can incorporate it into the pure nickel exophyte well. After analyze the three characterizations of the material, we also do the electrochemical testing about Heyan evolution reaction performance and Heyan evolution reaction stability. The lower the overpotential in the Heyan evolution, the better. It is a Heyan evolution reaction test. It can be seen from the figure that the black line is pure nickel sulfide material, the red line is chromium dot nickel sulfide material, and the blue line is putnam. Under the control of the same current density, 10 milliampere per cubic centimeter, comparing the three material, it is found that putnam has the lowest overpotential and the best performance, followed by chromium dot nickel sulfide. In terms of material stability, after a continued operation of 20 hours, the curve remained substantially unchanged and the stability was good. Please watch the full of a water splitting video of the chromium dot nickel sulfide material at 1.5 volt and 3 volt respectively. It can be seen that the chromium dot nickel sulfide material can also generate energy at a low voltage of 1.5 volt. We design and fabricate the chromium dot nickel exophyte nanomaterial supported on nickel foam as a highly efficient electrocatalyst for water electrolysis by an easy one-step hydrothermal reaction. We found that the chromium dot nickel exophyte nanoflower shows the best hydrogen evolution reaction performance of 81 millivolts. We wish our finding may provide a new way to design and prepare electrocatalyst for application. Thank you for your listening.